Now, I think it's pretty safe to say that the future of the Star Wars universe seems to be quite expansive, not just with their books, novels, comics, and video games, but also, let's not forget about their new Star Wars TV shows, the new Star Wars movies that are currently in the works as well, that will be further announced by Disney CEO Bob Chapek at Star Wars Celebration this year. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars updates. Also, by the way, guys, I am on Twitter at MikeZero1 if you guys want to go ahead and give me a follow on there. I do post a couple of entertaining things from time to time and really make sure to interact with you guys further. So we're now in a very interesting phase of Star Wars, given that we are going into the Book of Boba Fett Chapter 3 by next Wednesday, or this Wednesday, I should say. After that, you know, we only have a handful of episodes left that's going to run its way into early February, and that's going to eventually lead us to the marketing run of the Obi-Wan Kenobi TV series that's going to start in mid to late March, setting things up for a May of 2022 release. Now, the thing about everything related to George, John, and Dave is that they really are very busy behind the scenes, trying to do everything possible that they can to really turn things around for the franchise by mixing together Star Wars Legends and exactly what's actually already established, you know, the existing canon lore and such under Disney's wing. So, one thing about Celebration is that we will be learning more about the roadmap of the franchise that's going to give us a very in-detailed look at the overall structure of Star Wars and how it's really going to expand all the way until, at the very minimum, the year 2024 to 2025. And then Celebration 2023 is going to expand that roadmap, showing us more about everything related to the structure by John, George, and Dave. So, on top of all of this, what's really intriguing has everything to do with what's been going on behind the scenes with, of course, Lucasfilm's Kathleen Kennedy and exactly, you know, what has happened with Kathleen Kennedy for the past number of years now. So, with both Disney and Lucasfilm prepared to make big announcements at Star Wars Celebration this year for the new Star Wars TV shows and movies that will be released, it's described that both Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni are currently focused on their new Star Wars TV shows for Disney+. However, it's described that recently a Lucasfilm spokesperson was able to engage in an interview and talk more about Jon and Dave's treatment on the future of Star Wars and even went on to talk about Kathleen Kennedy. Now, the spokesperson went on to say one thing, of course, I can be very honest about, is what we are now allowing John and Dave to do with Star Wars. We have been so proud of them coming on board of the franchise to really provide a new treatment of the brand. In the beginning, it was, believe it or not, a bit of a struggle and a big struggle between Kathy Kennedy, John, and Dave falling into creative differences many times when Favreau was writing the Mandalorian series when it came to Season 1. This dates back to early 2019, when Kathleen Kennedy was not allowing Favreau to use much of the Legends material or big-name cameos for the first season of the series that he was supposed to put into the show. Now, this was prevented by Miss Kennedy. I remember there were discussions of using Luke Skywalker in multiple scenes for Mandalorian Season 1. So, one thing, of course, you know, that the spokesperson was able to provide is that there were supposed to be sequences in Season 1 that was going to involve Luke Skywalker in depth with a lot of action-driven sequences. Now, sadly, this never came to a reality because of those creative differences between John, Dave, and Kathleen Kennedy. Again, this isn't anything, you know, unexpected out of Kathleen Kennedy as a person or as a producer. We've seen her do things like this time and time again. And at the end of the day, I mean, it did work out well for Season 2. I will admit that using Luke Skywalker the way that they did as a big surprise and, you know, kind of using less but really making it very action-driven, it actually worked to kind of create this cliffhanger of what's going on with Grogu, what's going on with Luke when they leave, you know, Din Djarin and crew behind. It really makes you wonder exactly, you know, what's in store for Season 3, and we've been talking about Season 3 for a while now. There is a lot of scenes that are set to be filmed by this February to March that's going to involve a lot of aspects to do with Luke and Grogu. So that's one thing to take into consideration here. Basically, what Favreau wanted to do for Season 1 that was all pretty much prevented by Kathleen Kennedy is now going to be used in Season 3, thankfully. Moving on. So on top of all of this, He goes on to say, and this is something that Kathleen Kennedy thought was outlandish and unbelievable to the audience by using Luke. I always thought to myself, why wouldn't you want to use Luke Skywalker? I mean, he is the guy in the Star Wars galaxy, the character that everyone thinks about. What I can say is that Mr. Favreau was absolutely held back for season one, and that he had so much in store for the series beginning with Ahsoka Tano, and even Luke Skywalker appearing in multiple scenes. Now, Favreau had even bigger plans for season 2 at the time that was going to involve other big-name cameos, but that it was now, of course, being saved for season 3, which I believe many fans out there are going to really enjoy. The truth is, when we were shooting Mando season 1, Kennedy even wanted to dial back on the amount of references to the Force through Grogu. Kennedy wanted nothing to do with the Force or its power in season 1, and for the most part, that was accomplished through her demands. For season 1, originally fans were going to be in for a ride of fully packed action scenes involving Luke, Ahsoka, Boba Fett, Bo-Katan, and all those other fan-favorite characters. Now that we have introduced them in season 2, we are going to slowly build up to Jon Favreau's original vision for Mando season 1 that debuted in 2019, and how that's going to be done in 2022. We really are very ambitious about season 3, and we have so many surprises coming your way that's going to involve many twists and turns for the franchise, where it's our job to keep things interesting for the new Star Wars shows. And season 3 by Mr. Favreau and Filoni surely takes it to a brand new level that you will never expect to see, and I hope everyone enjoys it. So here's another thing that I think a lot of fans absolutely need to know, is that season 3 is going to have saga-wide implications. Basically, it's going to have a big effect on the prequel trilogy movies, and yes, even the original trilogy films, and how Grogu is going to play a large factor in all of that. So basically, Grogu is becoming the center of the Star Wars universe. That's what Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni are setting things up for. We already know that there's a handful of scenes that are being done right now as we speak, that are being filmed for Din Djarin and Grogu, so that really kind of answers some questions that there are going to be a, you know, specific key sequences in time that Din Djarin is able to get Grogu from Luke eventually. Now, we already know that Mando Season 3 is going to have multiple time jumps as well, so be aware of that as well. In the very beginning, Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni planned to create a time jump. So we're not quite sure how long it's going to be. It could be a year, maybe 3 years at minimum. Who knows? But they are going to be doing a time jump in order to explore that post-Return of the Jedi era without really doing it at a snail pace, basically. So overall, I think that what they're ultimately trying to do here is that they really are trying to dig up Jon Favreau's original vision. Again, this just goes on to prove that Kathleen Kennedy really wanted nothing to do with Luke, Ahsoka, Boba Fett, Bo-Katan, you name it. And she pretty much prevented all of that from happening in season one, unfortunately. We could have had all of that magic stuff in the first season and then save a lot more bigger things for season two. So it kind of created a ripple effect, right? Now season three is basically going to be what season one was supposed to be. And I think that's going to be a very interesting turn of events, to say the least, because now Favreau gets the last laugh. He is able to do exactly what he wants to do. He's going to be doing everything in his power to really explore and dive deep into those beloved Star Wars characters. So overall, guys, you know, drop a comment below. Let me know about all this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.